So here we go. So today we'll talk about smart devices and their security settings. I am Jitin, the counsel for Muscat Technology and Innovation Group, and also the counsel for the Simple Hangouts group at Muscat here. We are currently in a kind of semi-lockdown state. So we are, people who want to go out, they can go out, but with precautions, and people who want to just have fun online, they can do so. It's all their choice. So I preferred the second option to have some activity online, and here I am. So today we'll talk about the social media, the different social media applications, and how they can affect our personal life. So we all are using these devices, these technology, either by force or by choice. But if I ask you one question, that have they made your life easier or have they made your life better? So definitely most of you will answer in positive note, except those few people who have seen the negative side of it. And that is where the problem arises. There is no perfect solution for those negativities, but the only solution is that we have to be alert, we have to be aware. If we are aware, we can always safeguard ourselves. As we are trying to safeguard ourselves from this COVID with different precautions, we have to be cautious enough for technology as well. We have to be cautious enough. I have seen multiple incidences. You might have, of course, seen as well, where people have been cheated, where people have had losses in terms of money, in terms of their reputation and whatnot. The only problem was that they have taken this piece of technology or that small handheld device very casually, very lightly. And that is the reason why they had to face so many issues. I will be also looking at the comments if they're coming on the chat window. So what all things we can do so that we can be aware from the negative side effects of the social media. So these days, you know what, people, they are having a kind of fear in their mind, and that fear we call as FOMO, F-O-M-O. FOMO is a FOMO factor, we call it as FOMO factor, which says fear of missing. Fear of missing online. So we want to be everywhere. We want to be present in every social media website, in social media applications. We want to have all those apps which are new. We want to download them. We want to experiment them so that we don't miss out on anything. That's the fear which actually takes us to these applications, which can always attack us. So problem is that we have so many social media accounts, and sometimes, not all of us, but definitely some of us, and sometimes since we have so many accounts, we may not be so much regular in logging on to those accounts, in looking at those accounts. That's one very big problem, unattended social media accounts. Although we are all very busy in our lives with our jobs, with our works, with our family responsibilities, but yes, if we have got some accounts, we have to have certain kind of, as we do servicing for our vehicles or we do regular medical checkup for ourselves, we have to also see our social media accounts as well. Why we need to see that? Because from time to time, all these social media accounts, they are changing their policies. They are changing their security settings. So we should know that what is the new thing in the policy? What are the new security settings? And we should accordingly change ourselves as well when we are using those accounts. Then the next risk is human error. Sometimes we tend to make some errors. Sometimes we either keep our accounts open, we use very common passwords, sometimes we click on the wrong URLs, sometimes we click on the wrong advertisements which we see on those social media accounts, whether it's Facebook or it's Instagram or it's Twitter. And sometimes we may install certain applications on these social media platforms. I have always seen these Facebook accounts with lots of new applications. How will you be after 20 years? What will be your retirement life like? Who were you in your last birth? Some interesting applications which are going to predict something about you. What will be your car after 40 years, after retirement? How your house will look like? So all these applications are nothing but data sucking, vulnerable third party applications. Personally, I don't entertain these applications, and I also advise you not to entertain any of these applications which are giving you these kind of information. Then of course, you can also be victim to those phishing attacks and scams. All of us, we are humans, so sometimes we get some messages where we feel that, okay, we should help these guys, and then unknowingly or knowingly, we actually fall into a trap. So you should be very careful with that. We are receiving so many emails. We should know that whether this, if the email is not from a known person, then never click any of the URL which comes to you from unknown person. That is the first thing which I will suggest you. Never do that. This is a very recent incident from one of my friends' organization. They got an email, and email looked like from a known source. So the one person tried to open the attachment, he could not open. So what he did was, he said, look, buddy, I'm not able to open the attachment. Can you please check it? And he forwarded the same mail to his other colleague. And this email went to multiple people in the same organization. It's an IT organization, but it went to multiple people, and all of them tried to open that email. Ultimately, they had to pay a ransom amount to the hackers to get back the access to their own data. So we have to be always careful with whatever emails we are receiving, and with those emails, whatever links are coming. Sometimes they send some attachment files also, they send some Word document, they send some text document. Please don't open those documents. And imposter accounts, sometimes we get messages from the people who are known to us, looks like maybe one of my friend, somebody somebody take their profile picture, create a similar account, and then he is messaging you for something. You have to be very careful with that. Malware attacks and hacks are very common, of course. We'll talk about that later on. That's another topic, of course. And what we'll talk about today is privacy settings and unsecured mobile phones. So we'll talk about privacy settings in our social media applications. Today, I have taken two social media websites. One is Facebook, which is very popular, which is very common. And the second one is Twitter. So I'll talk about some of the common security settings of the Facebook and Twitter, and then I will move on to the last option, which is unsecured mobile phones. In between, if you have anything to share, or if you want to ask anything, please do so. Please unmute yourself, and you can ask or share your experience with us. So social media security tips, privacy settings, always choose a strong password. When I say this, believe me, no password is safe. If you have a password which comprises of all those characters on the keyboard, still with the current set of technology, with the current set of devices available, any combination of password which you can use for any website, it can be cracked maximum within 28 days. Maximum, if I'm saying. Your 8-10 characters password with your @, symbol, all those things, it takes not more than 5 to 10 minutes to crack those passwords. But if you are trying to have a combination of all those characters on the keyboard and you want to have a complex password, maximum it will take 28 days to crack any complex password which is there. So you have to choose a strong password. That is one thing. Keep on changing the password. If not every month, at least once in 3 months. That's one suggestion I would like to share with you. Use login approvals. So for login approvals, what I mean to say is all those applications, now they have an option. So if you're logging from a new device, then you have to approve it, kind of a check, like, is this you? So sometimes the check can happen through email, sometimes check can happen through the OTP or a SMS on your phone. So use that option so that if you are logging on from a different laptop or different device, you get a confirmation message on your phone number on through SMS or through OTP, and then you can verify that. That's a very good option. You should always use that. I hope most of you are using that. Enable login alerts and see who is logged into your account. I mean, that's another option which you can do so that if in case someone tries to log into your account, then you can always get an alert and see that, okay, who is logged into your account, from which place he has logged in, and you can always disable or enable that. If you have done it purposefully, it's fine, you can allow it. If you have not, if you don't know about it, you can just disable that. You can just cancel that login, and you can just disable that particular device for login as well. Audit the apps that have permission to access your Facebook account. We'll look into this feature now, that how you can allow or disallow the applications and what data they can access from your Facebook account, and peruse the rest of the security settings. So let's just have a look at this. So first of all, choose a strong password. So that's one recommendation. And how to go to the security settings. So all of you can just log into your Facebook account, go to the settings option, and go to the account settings option. It's not something which is very difficult. It's very easily doable for all of us. We can do it, and it won't take much time also, but we should do it. And why I'm showing you this is because we should change the password every 3 months. If not every month, at least every 3 months. These days, all the banking applications, they send you reminders for that. Facebook also, Facebook doesn't give a reminder to you, so you have to do it on your own. So you can always go through the settings option, and then you can go to the account settings option. And then from there, if you see, you have option security and then the login approval. So for the login approval means, how are you going to give the approval for the particular login which has been done by you or somebody else. So you can choose that option. And for that login approval, you can see that they will generate a code. So you can specify the code also, that whenever you log into a new device, a new system, you have to put this code. If you don't put this code, then that means that login will not be acceptable. So every time you log in, it will ask for a code. Like for example, all of you are using WhatsApp or Signal or any other application. So from time to time, it asks for a code just to authenticate that this is you. That's just a kind of security code so that it ensures that the person who is using the application is the original person, is the person who is authorized to do so. Also, you can use the option of remember browser. So that's another option. So whenever you log into a new system, let's say from outside, from your office, from a restaurant, from airport lounges or wherever you're traveling. So you can always choose this option, remember browser, or don't save. So when you remember browser, that means next time if you log in from the same place, it will not give you an alert. But if you say don't save, then you log in from the same browser or somebody else logs in from same browser, it will give you an alert that there is a new login from a specific browser from a specific location. And then you can always disable that login. All these alerts are coming through email, and you can also choose the option of SMS for the alerts as well. So alerts will come to you through SMS as well. And that gives a notification to you basically whether you want to approve these logins or not. Then if you want to see that who has logged into your account and what all devices are currently using your specific account, you can see that. So if you see here, settings and then security and the login alerts option. So you can see notifications, whether you want notifications or no. It says get notifications, don't get notifications, notifications through email or notifications through the SMSs. You can specify that here. You can specify a number also if you want to specify a number, and that will give a notifications to you for the login. That's important. And once you get the login notifications, you can accordingly react to it. That's the most important part, which I want to discuss with you. The applications that have permission to access your Facebook account. So you can just go to settings and apps option. I don't know. Maybe I will open this question for all of you at the end of the session, that are you actually using this feature of the Facebook application? First of all, are you all using Facebook? I don't know, because all the people whom I know in my friend circle, in my professional circle, most of them, they use Facebook. And I assume that most of you are using it as well. And not all of them, not most of them, but yes, some of them are using these additional applications, which are a part of those Facebook walls, or they come as a pop-up to those Facebook walls. So one of their friend has just clicked something on an application. It's showing that, okay, you will be spending your next spring in this country. And it gives a background, and it shows him lying down somewhere on the beach or somewhere. So, and then it gives a message, do you want to try out where you will be next spring? So you click on that application, and then it will ask you, do you authorize this application to use your personal information? You will say, yes, I want to. And then you don't know that who is the developer for that application, because you trust Facebook so much. And then you say allow. And then you click on a couple of more allows. And then you see the result that, yes, you will be in Bali in next spring, or you will be in some other country in next summer. And then you feel happy about it. And then you share it also. When you share it, the moment you share it, one of your friend looks at the same notification, he also clicks. And then what happens is, everybody who says allow, 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 all his personal details, which are associated with the Facebook, is also shared with that particular company who has developed that application. You don't know them. You know only Facebook, but these are all third party applications. So you must review once a while that in the past, how many applications I have used like this, and are they still having access to my data? So yes, you can go to settings and applications, and then you can see that what all applications are there. Click on any of the application, and if you feel that this is not valid, you don't want them to keep your data, just click on the remove option. Or if you want to see more details, you can see that in this application, which information from you is visible to them. So you can see from here that they can access your public profile, they can access your email address, they can access your date of birth, they can access your friend list, they can access your whatnot. I mean, they can access your even the movement. Probably you must be knowing about this also, that Facebook, when you're saying that the location services are on, so when you're moving from one place to another place, Facebook is actually tracking your location. So when you say check into a hotel, check into a restaurant, actually you're telling Facebook that I was in this place, then I moved to this place, and then I moved to this place. So Facebook keeps a track of all your movements. And then if you are using one of these applications and they have an option to access your location, so they can even access your location also. So tomorrow there is somebody in a part of world who knows about you, who knows about your daily movements, who knows that where all you go for shopping, where all you go for lunches or dinners or spending your free time in the evening. So they know about everything. They know, in fact, more than what your spouses are knowing about you. So that's a very interesting thing. So you must review this information at least once in a while and see that whether you actually want to share with them or not. So you can just, first of all, remove from here. I will be happy if all of you will just remove and keep it blank. Nothing is required. I don't want any of the applications to access my data. Keep it blank. It's not required. So that's one thing what you can do. And then, of course, you can see so many other options from here. You can choose that turn the platform option off. You can say apps that others people are using. You can disable these different informations which the apps can access from you, your bio, birthday, family, relationships, all these things. So you can just disable everything. I mean, even if you sign up to any other app, you can just limit your information. If you're so much interested, first of all, I'm saying don't do that. But in case if you want to, just minimize it to the minimal level and then use it. That will be a good choice for you. Another thing is the rest of the security settings, how can you restrict that? So you can also use an option for trusted contacts. Sometimes it may happen that you may forget a password. Normally what happens is when we sign in, we always save our passwords. And every time we sign in, we don't have to type our passwords, but it is saved in the system. So we don't bother to remember the password. Although some people are using password managers and other applications, but we don't bother to use it. So what I will suggest you that you can use this option, which is saying trusted contact. So just in case if you forget your password, you lose your laptop, you have to format your laptop, you lose your laptop or phone, everything. So you can use this option to enable or to reset your password. So that this is a very good option, trusted contacts. So what happens is this will get a confirmation from your side that yes, this is actually you who want to reset the password. So when you say trusted contacts, it actually sends a notification to those people that, do you know this person? They will say, if all of them, they say yes, then you can have access to the account. You can reset the password. I mean, it says that they will get a code. They have to give back the code to you, and then you can put the code and then you can reset the passwords. It's a very good option in case if you forget your password or by mistake your passwords are removed from your system, you don't remember it. So you can use this option for that purpose. Profile picture login, that's also a very good option so that you don't have to type the password every time you log into a system. You can just click on the profile picture and you can log in. Sometimes it's a good feature for the people whose devices are being used by multiple members in the house. So you may have multiple people in the house who are using same laptops. So they don't have to put the password every time. They can just choose, okay, mom wants to log in, dad wants to log in, or kid wants to log in, or the girl wants to log in. So they can just choose their profile picture and they can log in. So they don't have to type their password every time they want to log into the specific applications. That's a very good option from the Facebook. These are all different security settings from the Facebook. I can have a pause at the moment. And can I just ask you a question that are you using any of these security settings or no? So can I just stop now? Is the option to stop recording? Pause.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you. And let me continue quickly to the second part of my presentation. And the second part, I will talk about the Twitter settings. So Twitter settings is another, because that's another common application which everybody is using. So I thought I'll just go with the Twitter application. So if you see here in the Twitter, when you go to the home, click on the notifications, and then you click on the settings option. So once you click on the notifications and the settings option, then you will find all these different settings options are available to you. And then first of all, what notifications you want to receive. So you can choose which notifications you want to receive from the notifications tab. That's of course, it all depends whether somebody is tagging you, somebody is responding to with a message, somebody is following you, or you have followed some hashtags or some accounts and they have posted something. So all those notifications will come to you from these choices which you make here. And then if you want to review your account settings, so you can click on the your account options, and then you can see those different settings which are available here. Account information, changing the password, download and archive of your data. I'm sorry, I did not talk about the downloading archiving of the Facebook data, but that's something which you can do as well. You can always download whatever you have posted on the Facebook, all the videos, all the photographs, even if you have some chat conversations with anybody, all those data you can download from the Facebook and you can keep it safe with you. Because sometimes tomorrow, if you want to disable your account, before disabling, download everything what belongs to you and keep it with you. That's a good option. You can do same thing here also, downloading archive of your data and also the TweetDeck team, and also deactivating your account from the account settings. And then security and account access to factor authentication, which is a very common way of authenticating you these days. So you put a password, that's first authentication. Second is the OTP or a message which comes to you. So I will also always recommend you to choose this option for all your social media accounts, because whenever you log in, if somebody is logging from a new device, it has to have two-factor authentication so that you can check that somebody who is unknown he is having access to your account. So he may have access to your password through those hacking applications, but then the second device, the phone number, the OTP, he will not get. So you will be at least safe on that part. And then you have got, that's the last thing. Okay, that's it. And then of course you have got accessibility, display and languages. So all these options you can check how you want to display to be there. There are some color settings and all those themes which are available there. So that's all for this specific presentation from my side. Let me just stop the recording. For